Now, we tend to rely heavily on facial expressions to help us read other people's emotions, don't we? But what if you can't show your emotions easily because the muscles in your face don't move the way you want them to?
Facial paralysis or facial palsy affects around 1,500 people in our region each year. And now a young woman in York has enlisted the help of Fixers. That's the campaign that gives young people a voice. She wants to help others cope with the condition.
I think other people take smiling for granted. It's a universal language. People communicate with smiles. And if you find that when you're happy, you can't smile back, it can be quite depressing in some way. Your face is on display. You can't hide your face, but there come those moments when you wish you could. I'm Maria Munir, I'm 18, and I live in York. I was born with congenital facial paralysis. The facial nerve is affected, which means that my face is quite droopy on the left side of my face, which is where it's affected. Sleeping becomes very difficult because you find it so hard to get to sleep when one of your eyes is fixated on staying open. Eating is difficult because chewing is so hard. You might be trying to express a normal emotion, but someone might say, why are you putting that face? And I think that's when it has the biggest impact, that your face is different to everyone else's. I feel it's important for people to know that there are other people with facial palsy out there so they feel less alone.
So what is the key message that you're hoping to get across?
I want to show people that facial palsy can affect anyone at any time for any given period of time.
I'm working with Fixers to increase people's understanding of facial palsy.
So we're thinking along the lines of a poster campaign. What ideas have you got so far?
It's important for me to demonstrate that the condition can affect any aspect of your day-to-day life.
I think the greatest issue is the lack of support out there. People don't just need medicines, they also need emotional support.
Facial palsy is damage to the facial nerve. Facial palsy is no respecter of age, so it can happen to anyone, whether they're young or old. There are lots of different causes. The most common one is Bell's palsy. I think people with facial palsy feel very isolated. Even family and friends may not realise the difficulties that that person is facing every day.
I had a virus and I woke up one day and the first time I realised something was wrong was when I tried to take a drink of water. It turns out that my face was paralysed.
Today I'm talking with Amelia Tull from Ripon about her experiences with Bell's palsy.
It makes it difficult to speak to people, because you know that they're staring and they're not thinking about what you're saying or, you know, how you're feeling or whatever. They're thinking about, ooh, what's wrong with their face.
What difference would it have made if there had been a wider understanding of facial palsy?
I think it would have made a big difference because people would have realised how to kind of deal with you and how to approach you. So people understanding better would mean that there's less of a barrier to you overcoming what's happened and socialising with people.
To have such a big voice where I can reach people from all over the country is just brilliant, and I hope to use it effectively so that I can help other people and give them the chance that I had to make a difference.
That's Maria's story told with the help of Fixers. More on the website.